flight boss, bitch. You know, for sure. Flight morning, everybody. And you're now listening to the Mind of an Antares Moon. I'm the Archangel Uriel, and I'm here to carry out God duties and motherfucking responsibilities and waking flights and breaking flights, whatever the fuck you want to call it. God damn it, we in this motherfucker. And you know, I wanted to do an early video, you know, to try to get humanity out of, you know, the spookism type of thing. Because, you know, as spirits, we create spookism and things of that nature based upon the things we create. So we create the spookism behind it because we forgot how we created it. So for the most part, when we get lost into somebody else's imagination, influence, into somebody else's day, it end up becoming a nightmare for you. So you need to understand what kind of influence that you are up under, and we need to know how to not get lost into men and women interpretations of things, regardless of how old the civilization is. You know what I'm saying? I even got a request. People wanted me to break down the ancient Egyptian gods. Now, for the most part, for you to attach gods next to it, you need to know that you're just doing a shape and form of what we're doing now. You see what I'm saying? Deifying things because we forgot how we created these shapes and forms. So for the most part, this is what you need to understand. It doesn't matter what civilization you go through. It's always going to be a form of astrology. So when you go back to the Egyptian times, this is their way of astrology. So y'all call the sun today. So the way y'all interpret it for what they was talking about back then, they called it Atum. You know what I'm saying? So they called the sun Atum. So then you got Atum, and then you got Horus. Horus is what they call the houses. Because in astrology, this is where we derive the terms from, the horoscope. The scope of Horus traveled through the sky. Now, Horus is the motherfucking houses, right? So the ability from our scope of reference, we can see the travel of Atum through Horus, the horoscope. So we see Atum's travel through the sky. This is why Horus become the sky god, or some in some references they call it Nu. Because for the most part, when you the bigger the shape and form, that becomes the sun itself. So look at Atum, this sun, as a sun within a sun. So when we correlate the houses, the 360, we're within that 360. So we can only piece it out. So whatever part of the seed that you was born on this star, this chakra, that's the area and location that you could pinpoint the position of where you was born at. But once you get out of this realm, fourth, fifth, or sixth dimensional wise, and you're looking down, all this as a whole will be one. So all the houses, Aries through Pisces, that y'all want to call in this civilization, right? All these together, all those constellations together will be one constellation or will be one star. So that's what y'all will call as Horus or Nut. And the star in it, which is Atum, the smaller star that got created from it, travels within it. You see what I'm saying? So this was their way of understanding astrology. So this was their way of so all the ancient glyphs and things of that nature don't get lost in today's men and women interpretations of trying to interpret them or trying to decipher things that y'all want to call like the meta-nether and shit like that. You're just going to get information on what we thought they was talking about based upon a person's philosophical points of view. But if you sit back and understand what all civilizations are deriving, it don't matter what language they derive or come to the conclusion to understand what they're going through. Once you sit back and understand a certain pattern, you will start to put the pieces together and be like, oh, they just doing the same thing that we're doing now, just in their own way. Just in the way that they created, as far as language, ideas, and concepts, but it's still the same shapes and forms that they're bouncing off these ideas, concepts, and languages off of. So for the most part, when you go back and see the way that they was doing their sigils, you might be dealing with a very primal state of being. So they were very limited to access to elements, or they had a whole bunch of access to elements. But regardless of what they had access to, they was deriving and trying to understand the same thing that you are trying to understand today. So when you see certain signs and sigils and things of that nature, you have to understand that we're doing the same thing we're doing now, coming up with ways of understanding alignments, ways of understanding angles. And the better we understand angle and alignment, we know how to relate to each other. And once we know how to relate to each other, that slowly but surely manifests into us creating material or doing certain things with the elements amongst the plantation that we walk on. We get this information from higher alignments. So our ability to know when to harvest, when to farm, when to do certain things, when to do things behind closed doors, when to do things in secrecy, when to do things in privacy, when to do things as awakened time. We understood all this based upon receiving energy from when the sun be in this position, Then when the sun moves this position, then when the sun moves this position, so based upon the Egyptians, they was, this is how they was calculating things, and this is where all of their sigils and stuff come from. Basically keeping track of Atum, travel through the horoscope, travel through Horus, seeing Adam travel through the sky god. So them keeping track of this is why they looked at this like a god. But see, they didn't necessarily look at it like a god the way y'all trying to look at it. The God phrase is an interpretation from a civilization thousands of years after the fact. So since y'all believe in the quote-unquote term of God, how y'all think God is, then once y'all start to get deciphering and start to try to decipher what y'all thought they was talking about, since y'all worship the sun and y'all don't think, y'all don't know that's what y'all doing, and then y'all adding all this extra emphasis to God, right? Soon as y'all hear what the ancients was calling the sun, then y'all just remix y'all religion now and say, oh, this was they God. And then y'all start to try to pick up ways of how they was looking at the sun and start to correlate how everybody should look at spirituality and God. And then y'all remix that into the lost man of the people y'all call an oppressor who taught y'all that religious moral point of view. And then since you're detached from that, you just apply it to something that you think you are a lineage of, which you're just truly lost on a much larger level. So that's what I be trying to get people to understand, you know what I'm saying? Don't get too lost into men and women interpretations of trying to steer away from, we just know that man and woman was trying to understand the higher vessels that's above us in all civilizations. So the moment you step beyond that, you're getting a little spookism, you know what I'm saying? You're getting a little pseudo, you know what I'm saying? And you're starting to believe areas that you didn't actually live in yourself. You see what I'm saying? You didn't actually experience walking amongst them people like you're walking amongst your people today. And your people is all the races. So this is why I say don't be so much in a rush of trying to run and just live your whole life in the tropics or something like that somewhere. Because there's no information in the tropics. Remind you, information is where transformation is at. So if you're not in a place of where a lot of death is going along, a lot of birth is going along, aka a lot of transformation, a lot of imagination, a lot of creativity. If you're not in an area like that, then you're not in an area of information. So when you're going to a place of that's always hot and it's always the tropic, that's a place that we have already left from. So it can no longer play out the characteristics of us dying and being born and transforming and taking new shapes and forms to sustain ourselves in this astral travel. That's almost like standing in a space and location that we have already came from, and you're sucking on mother's titty, so you're scared to leave the nest. You see what I'm saying? So you're spiritually attached to this realm of reality in some way, shape, or form, and you're never gonna put yourself in no new experiences to attach new information to be able to sustain yourself through these new astral travels, aka these new experiences, these new bodies we're gonna be getting ready to go into. You're just gonna keep coming back here until it becomes deserted because it's familiar to you, and you think this is what nourishes you, and you think these things are here, and you think you're supposed to cling on to these things. Where psychology-wise, spiritually, we see that we're learning to live without sustaining ourselves with these things here. This is why we're coming up with GMO shit and artificial shit to sustain ourselves. The more we come up with artificial shit, the more we don't have to utilize, the more we subconsciously. Now, in an illusion, it may seem kind of fucked up, but spiritually in the fourth, fifth, and sixth dimensional realm, subconsciously we are training our minds to learn how to live without the body in some way, shape, or form. And we're coming up with all kind of new technologies that don't involve the physical fleshly body. And we can put our spirit in that and still experience in some way, shape, or form. So you need to understand that when you get sick and doctors come up with new medications or when you going through body dysfunctions and then they come up with crutches and things of that nature, this is a form externally that you don't have to utilize your fleshly body for. But your spirit can still sustain itself and be comfortable in some way, shape, or form. Which is why they made wheelchairs. A person can't walk anymore, so that's very uncomfortable. So for this spirit to sustain itself and to still feel comfortable in his day-to-day life, other spirits created things such as wheelchairs. So don't forget the minute, minor things that our spirits be doing that's right in front of us to show us our travels, and don't get lost into men and women interpretations of these things because we have got lost and forgot why we creating these things. See, I just broke it down on a smaller scale to help you understand that most lost spirits is doing this on a larger scale and are spiritually lost because they have obtained so much information in the third dimension. So they just went, they just took their spirit into more lights, more lostness. So you need to keep this in mind. Every civilization have their way of understanding astrology, aka perceiving the extraterrestrial vessels that you are within. So this gives you the understanding that you are a star and a moon. You are a day moon, day month, whatever you call that. A sun and a moon. You, this is with a day. That's why every time you walk, you go outside, you be like, okay, this is 2 day. Because it's always 2 days in one. You see what I'm saying? So don't correlate that with midnight and day rise. That ain't got nothing to do with nothing. This is why certain days is longer than other days. Because this is a rotation thing. No, y'all think the sun is going up and down. This is merely based on rotation. That's another video though. But for the most part, when we say 2 day, that's because we have a masculine shape and form and a feminine shape and form that controls each spectrum. So every time we move through a space, that space is ruled by a masculine and a feminine shape and form. This is why we got Mars and Venus. And back then they called it something else. This is why we got Jupiter and Mercury. This is why we got Saturn and Neptune and Uranus and Pluto. You see what I'm saying? And this is why we got the sun and the moon. So when you say today is always ruled by two, and one is going to be the masculine, and that's going to be the one that we call that day. And then it flips side on the feminine energy. You see what I'm saying? So for the most part, like I said, 2 day. You know, every time you wake up, what's going on today? You always know that the two closest bodies of water, chakras to us, is the sun and the moon. See what I'm saying? So keep that in mind. So you might as well say moon day. A day is a sun. That's a masculine figure. You know what I'm saying? And two, that's duality, the feminine energy. That's the moon, the reactionary energy, the responsive energy. So you have to know energies first before you dive into any type of philosophy or any type of intellect coming from men and women. You know what I'm saying? You have to understand spirituality and understand energy. You know what I'm saying? And then once you understand energy, the names that certain men and women gave these things might not ever be what they are. Same way with fire. If anything, fire is like contain electricity. So fire didn't even have to be the word for fire. But since y'all done created fire and the way it looks and flames and shit like that, y'all done created a bunch of sciences behind that. So now that done trickled into astrology, where we will actually come up with sciences saying that if the sun is in a sign, it will burn that sign out. Where technically the sun is not even hot. The only reason you feel heat is because that body of water is close to this body of water. So in between is going to create friction. So friction as a blood cell or ascended cell, whatever you fuck y'all want to call yourselves, right? Friction always creates temperament. Now y'all have created all kind of algorithms with temperament, so it have manifested into what y'all call temperature and waves, but heat waves and shit like that. But it's really just a high magnitude of chaotic transformation and friction going on at the moment when two chakras is this heavy waves. But y'all look at waves like air and a condensed wave that y'all call wave that's coming from water. Y'all limitations of knowledge stops there. Once y'all start to get into light rays and air direction and stuff like that, y'all kind of leave the water wave science to the side and start to get into something else where you need to understand it's just the same thing. It's just on a higher frequency. And based upon you being on a body and what level of body you created, this is going to let you know what information that you're going to be able to receive within this sphere. So this is why the lower the animal is, like if it's a snake, an animal that can only walk on four and things of that nature, the development of sight and the way that they can receive this imagination, the way that they see the world, aka receive this imagination, is going to be very limited. You know what I'm saying? And they may not be able to see a lot of things. So this is why you see like bugs or rats and stuff like that, they run into walls, and snakes and shit like that, they run because they can't see the physicality as that solid yet. Like something that may be very small and just a very shapely, right, might be a very large spectrum to them, but it might be very small. So they find themselves running into things, and like even cats and dogs and stuff like that, they're limit. So then the sphere, the level of frequency of the sphere you came out of, and you started developing your alpha wave, because you're really just floating. You're just in this body as a spirit, but really technically you're just floating. Do you think you in this? That's another video. But in this spectrum of the sphere, that frequency vibration that you're dancing on, right? You're more of the star. You're more of the five anchor in. So you're able to perceive more sharpness and more definition, right? So it's more at a sharply state. So the elements to you could be more sharper than and more smaller than the animals and the bugs that's smaller than you. Then once you get to the bugs are, and the animals that's born in a higher frequency to you, like birds and shit like that, that was born in the air and shit like that up there, for the most part, they're able to receive lighter spectrum. So they can see wider as more sharper. You see how it goes? Like, the smaller the element is, the wider they see it as the smaller the animal. Then you is, you can see a smaller, it's not as wide. That small thing is not as wide to you as the animal. And then for birds, that small thing to them is definitely is not as wide to them as to you. So they may not even see it. It may be thin. So to a bird, this is why they can physically see air. And this is why you can't physically see air. But you can physically see something as small as this. But then that's why an animal smaller than you can't physically see. You see what I'm saying? It's like the bigger you is a realm of reality. And then what frequency you was born in, like what sphere you was born in within the sphere. That's why y'all got atmosphere, this sphere, this sphere. What, depending on what spirit you are, what part of the waters you came out of, and then where you're floating at based upon what area you was born at, that lets you know what kind of race you're going to create for yourself. So if you're a human right now, that lets you know you came up out of the water, you came up out of the land, and right now as a ghost, you're floating like right here, right now, in this sphere that we're in. So you're floating like right here. So you control the whole in between. You know what I'm saying? You control everything below you and you control everything above you. Now, when I say control, that don't mean take authority over or give rulership over. No, that just means the spectrum you are in, you had a more balanced spectrum where you can see kind of 50% of this spectrum and 50% of the lower spectrum. So you're not imbalanced as far as the shape and form or the vehicle you chose to come into in this realm of reality. And you may have already been in those ones. So you already got balance. And the most balanced beings is the ones that's getting closest to the sexual organ to be spit out into the next, the bigger realm of reality, the 4th, 5th, and 6th dimensional sphere. When you get out of 1, 2, and 3 dimensional sphere and then get into the 4th, 5th, and 6th dimensional sphere. So a lot of times what y'all be calling like the most high is really the most low too. You need to understand that. And you're talking about something that's in time. So if you want to talk about y'all want to go get all y'all fake consciousness and be like, God ain't in time and God ain't in a physicality world and shit like that. Yet y'all want to cling something to the most high. That most high is the most low, is a spirit that's in this physical world in some way, shape, or form. Because it's the most, aka it got more or something. So it accumulated a shape and form or energy force. So it has something to do with this realm of reality, period. And we should be able to pinpoint it somewhere. And then for the most part, to call it the high, y'all giving things a location. So something higher than you isn't necessarily an authority over you. A bird is over you. But spiritually, you have existed longer than that in this realm of reality than that spirit that's in that bird. Otherwise, that bird would have took a shape and form that was more balanced in the sphere, like you. But it didn't. So you got attained to more knowledge here. So for the most part, for you to call something the most high, you're lost in direction, aka a man or a woman philosophical point of view about where we're at in some way, shape, or form. Where there is no direction, you have to create your own direction and map in the 4th, 5th, or 6th dimension. So when you calling something the most high, you're pointing to something that you worship that's in the 4th, 5th, or 6th dimension that want to remain its positioning and want to remain its location. And it's a demon, it's a spirit that's in a body that's playing out demonic characters because it's attached to this realm of reality in some way, shape, or form and never left. Otherwise, you wouldn't have information to praise it, to keep it here. So it had been in a most low state at one time, once upon a time. So for the most part, it's bouncing up and down and teach y'all all this up and down and ascended energy, and y'all are lost to the highest degree. So y'all are following Satan or something. Not even Satan. I mean, because that's just the opposer. But for the most part, that spirit in that body taught y'all how to have opposers. So anything that doesn't match y'all most high, y'all get into opposing energy and manifest trial and tribulation and being hung on a cross for your damn self. And the opposer get to sit back and be happy and look at you be stupid. And all you get to do is complain and be like, why all the demons and the Satans always getting everything and they controlling everything and they doing this thing? No, you just giving your fucking power away. Period. 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 So what I mean by that is, motherfuckers need to understand that when you're talking about the most high, you're just talking about the most high shape and form, aka a spirit that have ascended in a body before you, aka, and if you're still thinking about that motherfucker, that's a demonic spirit. So you're talking about the most high in this realm of reality, something that's higher than you as based upon space and positioning. And when we talk about the overall God, the overexpanded God, it ain't got nothing to do with space. You in a space and position. So why the fuck God would give a fuck about a space and position when you in it? It's your fucking fault you lost and following someone else who got another space. Motherfucker. Flight boss, bitch, goddamn air, ee-hee. and we in this motherfucker.